Finally at the time that we get to try the beaver tail. We went up to Ontario, Canada, went up to Buckhorn Canoe Company and talked to Dick Persson, the owner of the Buckhorn Canoe Company, and he explained to us the difference between the padded tail and the otter tail. And at that point in time, I had never really tried the otter tail. So in this particular video here, you heard Dick's explanation of the difference between the two. And I had never tried the ottertail, so I figured it was about time to try an ottertail. So I went to Patten, Maine, and I went to the Dri-Ki Woodworking Company, and I met with Rick Kim, the owner, and he measured me for an ottertail. And there's various ways of measuring for the ottertail, and the way that he measured with me was to stand up and from the bottom of my chin to the ground, and he made me a custom ottertail. So we are now here in Sunapee, New Hampshire, and I have used the beaver tail, which is a fairly wide blade, 7 inches or so. I've used a bent shaft paddle, but today is the first time I'm going to use my ottertail. So we're gonna give it a whirl and we're gonna see what happens here.
First time, look at that. It's a nice paddle. Nice paddle. Nice paddle. It's not too long.
Just the right height then, huh? Here's Dundee demonstrating the J-stroke with his brand new ottertail paddle. And you will notice he's keeping the paddle in the water as he comes forward with it. He's got the backward stroke and it's coming in. What do you think? How's it feel?
It looks beautiful. Very nice. Nice and smooth.
You look good and very comfortable in it.
Yep.
This is Outdoor Steve. Nice. Sunapee, New Hampshire, saying, I never have to say I have not tried an ottertail paddle. We wish you happy canoeing.